Hi, and this tip for this month on Elite Golf Coach, we're going to be talking about how to strike those fairway irons, the 7, the 6 irons. You've hit a decent drive, you're in position, you've got a 7 or a 6 or an 8 iron for the green, a mid iron, and suddenly you're missing the greens, you're in the bunker, you're making bogeys. These are the clubs really where you should be starting to try to call those shots back, put yourself in a birdie or par opportunity. So, the key elements for getting the strike right with a 7-iron for me are, when you take your setup, first of all, the ball position. Now, what I like to really see for a sand pitch 9-8-7, really pretty much the mid-irons, I like to see the ball position pretty much central, okay? You're not going to go too far wrong strike-wise if you get your ball position relatively central. What I tend to see with people with their mid-irons, they get the ball too far up in the stance, so they get too shallow angle attack and get a lot of missed strikes. If the ball goes too far forward, the club is moving more into an upswing, so it gets shallower generally, so it gives you more fins and fats. Or the ball gets too far back, because people are trying to hit down on it, and they get too steep, and they take all the loft off the golf ball, they start hooking it and cutting it. So when you do your setup, get your feet together. If I just show you this, club down, feet together, take your setup, and then literally a nice 50-50 stance, same distance each way, with the feet shoulders width, and the ball in the centre of your stance. That's going to get the correct angle of attack for those mid-irons, which is going to give you a nice descending blow, but not get you too steep or too shallow, which is going to affect the flight or the strike. So, get your stance, feet together, 50-50, get the ball central. Now this is the real key element. When you take your setup, make sure the shaft is sitting slightly forward. Too many people get the club shaft sitting level, or even a little bit back, or vice versa, way too far forward, especially the guys with the strong grips, way too far forward. What I mean by this is, when you take your setup, the top of the grip should be pointing in towards your left thigh. That's the same for every single golf club. Whenever you take your setup, the top of the grip pointing towards your, pretty much your left groin. That's your position. So you can see here the shaft is now leaning slightly forward of the club head. And what that does, that encourages the compression. You watch the tour players, you see them at impact. As they come into impact, you'll see the top of the shaft will lead. The club will be slightly behind, and they'll compress that golf ball. They'll get that lovely strike, ball and turf. You'll always see it in the slow motions, the ball, then the turf. That descending blow gives you a nice compression. If the shaft is sitting backwards, what you'll see is too much release, the club working this way, adding loft, showing the bottom of the club, the golf ball, and lots of missed strikes. So when you play the shot, ball position central from mid-iron, hands slightly forward, so the top of the grip pointing towards the left groin. And then from there, what I want you to really focus on is a nice follow through. I want you to focus on the foot coming up and the club finishing behind the head. So when I finish my swing, the club is behind my head, I've turned my body, and very importantly, the right foot has come up. Now the importance of that is delivering the body weight. The right foot is delivering the body weight into the golf ball. And as the body weight comes forward, that's what's going to get you striking down into that ball and give you that lovely strike, that ball and turf strike. What we do want to see is people trying to lift and lean back. I see lots of that, very flat footed swings, you know, arms doing all the work, or the people really trying to actually lean back and lift. It's the worst thing you can do in golf is lean back and lift. It just makes it go lower. You'll just thin it or fat it. The loft is here, like I was talking about in the pitching and the earlier tips, use the loft. You don't need to manipulate and add it. Let the loft of the club do the work. So in summary, ball position, feet together, 50-50 shoulders width. Shaft just leaning slightly forward. So the top of the grip is pointing in towards your left groin. That's a checkpoint for you because we don't want to overdo it. Take all the loft off there. And then from there, the focus is on the nice follow through. Letting the right foot come up at impact. So we see a little bit of heel raise at impact. The heel starting to move up, which will deliver the weight forward and allow the hips to clear. And then from there, I'm going to turn my right foot through. So I'm just going to show you this now. Here, shaft forward, there, and turn. And that puts my toe facing forward. I'm going to show you this from the other angle. Taking my setup, feet together, 50-50, shaft leaning slightly forward. And then from here, I'm going to focus my right foot coming up into impact and holding my finish. Good. You see there, as I struck that, I got a nice divot, So I got a nice bit of compression when I got the ball first. You can hear that sort of fizz off the golf ball. So when you go to hit those mid irons, ball position central, good wide stance, shaft leaning slightly forward, and then focus on turning through it so you're letting the weight go forward with that right foot coming up into impact. So you deliver that weight. And use that and you'll see a big difference in that mid irons and getting that strike in. I hope that helps you, and we'll see you for our next tip.